I will learn about the classes. Same, go for the class folder, index, inspect, console. Jump to main.js. So as of the most programming language, the syntax is very simple. Class name, there is an extend keyword. Let's start with this class. Class name, there is a constructor. Constructor will be used to instantiate object memory. So there is a this keyword also, just to reference who is calling that function or who is holding the memory. Same, there is another class rectangle which extends shape, means this extends the properties of this class. And under its constructor we are calling super, and that means we are calling this constructor. So this rectangle class, here we are creating an object new, we are passing 1020. This 1020 will come here, heights and width, and this will be jump to super, means this constructor, and it will get here 10 and 20, and it will come to the context of this heights and width. So after that we try to call the calci area, and this it is returning this dot height and this dot width, and we are having this dot height and this of width 200, 10 into 20. After that we have a area. So what is an area? It is a getter method. For that we have to write a get keyword as a prefix for it. For it just act as a property. It is a object p, and you can access it as a property of that. You don't have to use the round brackets. Now there is a static method. This is a keyword static. So static method can be called only with the class name. So the benefit of the static method is it can be used as a global method for all the instances of that class. For a practical example, for you are having a counter of how many instances have been created. So whenever you are creating an instance, you can increment that the counter in the static, using the static variable in the static member of that class. So that static variable will be shared across all the instances of that class. So as we know that a body of the object can be transferred to a variable, so here also the body of an calci area, this it is transferred to A. And suppose we are trying to execute that A, so it will throw an error that can't read the property height A of undefined. What happened? We go to its body, then it's try to do the return. Let's jump to its code. So we jump here. What exactly happened? So when we go here, we dumped his body in A and try to execute it. So let's jump here. So first it got here, then it's not directly now it got to console A. Then we have a body of A, and we will try to execute it. Now it will jump to calci area. Now what happened? Now that this is undefined, but previously it was working, but now that this is undefined, if it is undefined, then there will be no height, there will be no width. What happened? So when we tried to dump this calci area, P of that calci area to its, what happened that only this body has been transferred, but this means the this is referring to this object, but the memory of the object or the this reference has not been transferred to this. So for avoiding that kind of scenario, so that we cannot get this is undefined, what we do, we transfer this body, plus we transfer this P also with binding it. So if you are transferring any method and you are binding the object also, that means you are transferring the object memory also. In that case, whenever you call this and this statement comes, it will know that this is this object which has been bind. So let's comment this out. This now come to this and this. Now refresh it. Now we have come to this. Now we have binded the instance explicitly to this. Now come to this. As you can see, now that this will retain its values because we have explicitly binded the object memory to the function body at last. That's all. Thank you.